also. So this is known as cross tolerance. Okay. Next is tachyphylaxis. It is derived from the word where tachy means fast and phylaxis means production. It refers to a rapid development of tolerance when doses of a drug repeated in quick succession results in marked reduction in response. This is usually seen with indirectly acting drugs such as ephedrine, tyramine and nicotine. So tachyphylaxis is somewhat similar to acquired but not actually acquired type of tolerance. Acquired tolerance means after 6 months or after 1 year tolerance will develop. But in case of tachyphylaxis, within a week or within a month, not only a month, within 1 week or 2 weeks, tolerance may occur in tachyphylaxis. That's why we call it tachy. Tachy means fast. Fast tolerance means tachyphylaxis means fast tolerance, and it usually occurs with indirectly acting drugs. So we'll have an example and you'll get to know this thing. Suppose this is a neuron that contains norepinephrine. So obviously it is a noradrenergic neuron, and this noradrenergic neuron have got a carrier protein, a transporter protein known as NET transporter, that is norepinephrine transporter. Suppose this is a blood vessel and these are the alpha receptors. So whenever this norepinephrine comes and bind with the alpha receptor of the blood vessel, it will leads to vasoconstriction. It will constrict the blood vessel, and this thing is very much required in hypotension. So any person who is suffering from hypotension, what we want is, means this norepinephrine should release and it should combine with the alpha receptor of the blood vessel to produce vasoconstriction, and hypotension will be treated. But whenever norepinephrine is present outside its neuron or in the synapse, NET transporter, this norepinephrine transporter will get activated, and it will cause reuptake of the norepinephrine back into the neuron. Okay, so this is the thing happening. So any person who is suffering from hypotension, what we want is, we want this norepinephrine to get released out. It should interact with the alpha receptor present on the blood vessel and produce vasoconstriction so that the blood pressure should be corrected. So to do so, we consume a drug known as tea. Okay, tea is for tyramine. So what we are doing here is, we are giving this drug. So what this drug will do, whenever we consume, suppose we have got how many norepinephrine in our neuron? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, so we have got 6 6 norepinephrine present inside our neuron, and suppose we gave a drug that is tyramine. Okay, tyramine is our drug. Suppose we gave 2 molecules of tyramine to a person who is suffering from hypotension. So what will happen, this tyramine, it utilizes the same NET carrier protein, and tyramine will move inside and it will displace 2 norepinephrine outside. Okay, so this norepinephrine will interact with the alpha receptor of the blood vessel, produces vasoconstriction, and hypotension will be corrected. Okay, now again, that person, again he is suffering from hypotension, again after some time he took 2 molecules of tyramine, 2 molecules were mediated inside the neuron via the same transporter, and this transporter, it will replace it by displacement of 2 norepinephrine. Okay, this is the kind of displacement reaction. 2 molecules of tyramine moving inside, 2 molecules of norepinephrine moving outside. And these 2 molecules of norepinephrine will interact with the alpha receptor, produce vasoconstriction, and again hypotension was corrected. Now, again that person got an attack of hypotension. So again that individual took 2 more molecules of tyramine. So these 2 molecules of tyramine move inside and it displaced 2 norepinephrine from the neuron into the synapse, and then the hypotension was corrected. Now again that person got an attack of hypotension, so again that person took 2 molecules of tyramine, and this tyramine moved inside, but the hypotension was not corrected. Okay, why the hypotension was not corrected? Because there is no more norepinephrine stored present. Even if you increase the dose of tyramine, then also the action will not be produced. So this is known as tachyphylaxis, which occur with the indirectly acting agent. So tachyphylaxis is the rapid development of tolerance when doses of a drug is given repeatedly in a quick succession results in marked reduction in the response. So as you saw, initially the action was coming because there was a store of norepinephrine inside the neuron. But once the norepinephrine store has been completely over, then after that the action won't be produced. So that is known as tachyphylaxis, and it usually occurs with indirectly acting agent. Like this Taramine is an indirectly acting agent. Taramine itself will not produce vasoconstriction. It will cause displacement of norepinephrine, and that norepinephrine will act well on the alpha receptor, and then vasoconstriction will be produced. So this is known as indirectly acting drugs. So tachyphylaxis mainly occurs with indirectly acting drugs. So please do not confuse tachyphylaxis with acquired tolerance. Acquired tolerance means here induction of the enzyme occurs, and after 6 months or after 1 year, tolerance will be produced. But in case of tachyphylaxis, within 1 week or within 2 weeks, tolerance will be developed. And tolerance, why it is developed? Because there is no more store of norepinephrine available over here to produce the action. So that is known as tachyphylaxis, and this completes our tolerance topic.